Welcome, welcome to Spirit Journeys Radio. My name is Rita Ricks, and I am so delighted that you're here with me this evening. We have an amazing show. I can only tell you how excited I am that my guest is already in our virtual green room, and you will be hearing from her in just a few minutes. And so, to get started, I want you just to relax. You know, this is a special time on Tuesday night where you have an opportunity to simply sit down and relax. Make sure that you have your journal and your pen in front of you. I was talking to a listener today, and she said she typically forgets to get it, and then she's running around looking for it. So I'm telling you right now to get your journal and your pen so you will be able to take notes as we spend time talking to you this evening. And remember, if you want to talk with us at any point and you're live on the phone, all you have to do is press 1. So I want to move into my coach's conversation very carefully and intentionally, because you should remember that we have been talking about being in the present this entire month. We've talked about being mindful. And that's where I want you to be this evening. I want you to begin to practice slowness. Isn't that interesting? I want you to practice slowness. I want you to get rushing out of your head. And I have clients that sit in front of me all the time, mainly women, admittedly, who just talk with me about how they're doing so much. There's so much that they have to do. They're overwhelmed. They have all of these different hats that they're wearing, and they don't want to hurt anybody's feelings with saying no, and they are absolutely overwhelmed. So I am giving you permission, as a result of having talked about being present this entire month, I am giving you permission to practice slowness. Because often, and I want you to do this, because oftentimes we think that we can improve our lives by meeting our goals, by succeeding at our business, by finishing a college degree, by going on vacation, by doing anything else that will happen tomorrow. And what I really want you to take away from this month's theme, and tonight as well, is that right this moment is all we have. This is all we have, is right this moment. So, rather than looking at tomorrow for what might happen, why don't you, and I found this by Leo Babrata, and I just love this. This is under practicing slowness and being present. Slow down instead of rushing, even when you're in your car. And I have done that, and I know that people go around me or they jump in front of me. And I said this last week, it doesn't matter. I know that I'm going to get to where it is I need to go be, because I leave in plenty of time to get there. The rushing and the danger comes when you're not taking care and managing your day and your time. So you have to look at your calendar at the beginning of the day so that you can figure out how long do I need to take. And then while you're in the car driving, you can spend that time with the radio off just kind of observing those things that are around you. So that's my first suggestion. Slow down instead of rushing. Secondly, pause to savor the current moment. And I remember we used this word earlier in the month, savor the moment. Spend less time focusing on yesterday. Spend less time focusing on tomorrow. And spend more time savoring the moment, savoring the breathing, the breath that comes in and out of your body. Savor the smell of good food. Savor the taste of the food. I suggested, I think it was in the first or second session of this month, that every so often, cut off the TV, cut off everything that's making noise, and just have a meal in the silence The food is amazing. You can't imagine how good it is because you're really concentrating on it. So savor the current moment. Next, I want you to think about everything about a moment and find small things to appreciate. There are times when we're frustrated. There are times when it's raining. There's time when the weather's bad. There's time when things don't go the way we think they should go. But you have options. You can either concentrate on what's not going right, or you can concentrate on what is going right. Because I promise you, there is absolutely something wonderful going on in your life. You just have to decide that you're going to pay attention to it. So I want you to notice everything about the moment and just enjoy it. That goes back to savoring. Find small things to appreciate. Number four, be grateful for what there is right here, right now. I had to take a friend to two doctor's appointments today. And I just was amazed at the number of people that came in and out, and I could see some of the challenges that they were facing. And one of the places that we went was a cancer clinic. And I don't think about people being ill because, thank God, I'm healthy. But there are a lot of people who are ill. And so if you are just grateful every day for your health, for the ability to be able to get back and forth, for the ability to be able to communicate, for the ability to be able to make decisions, that's a blessing. And that should be done every day because nothing is promised. And so in this moment right now, you can say, I am grateful for where I am. I am grateful for being healthy. I am just grateful. The next one is to allow things that are bothering you to just be in your life without fighting them, without pushing them away. And we talked about this last week. Sometimes it's okay just to sit in the moment if you're sad or unhappy or grieving. It's okay to sit in the moment, even if you're mad. It's okay to sit in the moment to figure out, where's this coming from? Why do I feel this way? And certainly if there is grieving going on and you are missing the person, that's the time to really be silent and just allow God to love on you. If you're mad, and you figure out what it is you're angry about, 9 out of 10 times, it's probably something that you allowed to happen. Because remember, we tend to create our own reality. But if you can sit in that moment when you are out of alignment, if you will, and just allow God to just hold you, you can get back into alignment. You can get past the sadness, the grief, or whatever, the anger. You can get past it. The challenge comes when you choose to stay in that moment and allow the next moment and the next moment and the next moment. And you stay in it. As I said, stay in it for the moment and then get out. The last one is don't allow little things to offend you because they're not worth ruining the moment. Again, you have choices. Do you want to take the good from the day or do you want to focus on the bad? Do you want to spend the time really thinking, this was a great day. It was chilly this morning, but then the sun came out. Did you have a chance to walk? If you didn't yesterday, plan it for tomorrow. You could walk around even as you're listening to this show. You could be walking back and forth in your house and getting those steps in while you're listening to this show. We have options, and that's what I want for you, is to practice slowness, to practice more about being present, to spend more time being mindful of this moment and enjoying it. I also want to read some quotes that I think are just really interesting. And the first one, let me make sure. The first one reads as follows. Time isn't precious at all because it is an illusion. What you perceive as precious time but the one point that is out of time, the now. That is precious indeed. The more you are focused on time, past and future, the more you miss now, the most precious thing there is. And that comes from Eckhart Tolle. You know, I was concerned about getting a project done in a particular short amount of time. And the guy that I was working with on the project, I said, I just want to do it because it doesn't feel like there's enough time. And he said, you know, Rita, we're doing this project for God, and God doesn't wear a watch. Huh, I thought, okay, we can get this done. I just need to continue to stay mindful of the present. Here's another quote, and this is by the gentleman who wrote this article, Leo Babada. He says, we're so caught up in trying to do everything, experience all the essential things, not miss out on anything important. We can't read all the good books, watch all the good films, go to all the best cities in the world, try all the best restaurants, meet all the great people. Life is better when we don't try to do everything. Learn to enjoy the slice of life you experience, and life turns out to be wonderful. I love that. I got another one. This is by Rashid Ogunluru. He says, the greatest gift you can give yourself or anyone else is just being present. And I'm almost sure I mentioned this last week. When we are talking to children, we need to give them our undivided attention. And, of course, that goes for anybody, but especially children, because we don't always think of them as little people. We just think of them as kids. But they deserve our attention because they are watching us. They're learning from us. They're growing as a result of watching us. And so we need to give them our attention so that we can help with their self-esteem, so that they can begin to feel, wow, somebody's listening to me. I must have something to say. So I'm going to repeat that the greatest gift you can give yourself or anyone else is just being present. Here's number four. When we know love, fear has no value in our presence. There is no pressure to perform and mask our humanity. We can be. And when we be, we can inspire others to be. Let me say that again. When we know love, fear has no value in our presence. There is no pressure to perform and mask our humanity. We can be. And when we be, we can inspire others to be. And I said this before, we are human beings, not human doings. So let's just be. Number five, almost all sadness comes from thinking about the past, and all worry from thinking about the future. Present mindedness is your only safe haven. So what I encourage you to do is to choose one thing, do it to the best of your ability, let it go. Pick something else and repeat this process endlessly. That's life in the moment. That's life right now. I hope you enjoyed this coach's conversation. I want to remind you real briefly that this Saturday is time again for the 5th annual Let's Get Serious Health, Wellness, and Fitness Expo. Those of you who have attended this expo before can attest to the fact that this event is nothing but pure family fun. So come on out again for that this year. Last year, Cherie Cofield International hosted over 1,000 attendees, and the goal this year is at least 1,300 registered attendees. So visit letsgetserious.eventbrite.com to register for this free event. And again, it's this Saturday, April 4th. I'm going to go let you hear from some other sponsors, and when we come back, I am going to introduce you to Evangelist Marcietia S. Glenn. Hang in, I'll be right back.
Hey, Chef Jovi here of the Eat Experience Radio Show. Join me 10 a.m. every Thursday to explore recipes, best restaurants, and food spots in and around the country. I look forward to receiving your comments, so follow us on Spreaker.com to tune into the show. That's Spreaker.com. And search MWHY Radio to join me every Thursday, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, for the Eat Experience Radio Show. And remember to share your Eat Experience.
If you're the parent of a child with behavioral challenges that has been suspended, expelled, or just not able to make it in a traditional school setting, there is an alternative. Call the Metropolitan Day School today. Licensed and accredited grades K through 12, call 804-321-2595. Financial assistance and after-school programs are available. Let's turn this school year around right now at the Metropolitan Day School, where eagles soar. Call Ms. Thomas today, 804-321-2595.
Hello, I'm Sherelle of Fit and Flow Yoga Radio. Wake up with me every Friday at 6 a.m. and have a wonderful yoga experience. We'll explore meditation and discuss how various yoga postures can help relieve your everyday stress. We'll also make the connection between our faith and wellness. Follow us on Spreaker.com to tune into the show. That's Spreaker, Spreaker.com. And also search MWHY Radio to join me every Friday at 6 a.m. for Fit and Flow Yoga Radio with Sherelle. And until next time, surrender to your strength and always embrace your flow.
Hi, this is Benita with Off the Vine. Join us on Fridays at 3 o'clock for fun talk about wine. This season, I'm going to put this little sommelier certification to work as we expand the conversation to talk about beer and spirits, too. Meet more exciting special guests, and you never know just who may show up at the studio. Off the Vine with Benita on the May We Help You Radio Network, giving you something to whine about.
Thanks for staying with me. I am so honored and pleased to be introducing tonight First Lady Mother Marcietia S. Simmons Glenn, the wife and helpmate and life partner of Bishop Gerald Glenn, pastor and founder of New Deliverance Evangelistic Church, and they are the parents of 5 children. They are the proud grandparents of 9 grandchildren, and with great joy, she balances being a wife, mother, Nana, First Lady, counselor, and friend. And I am going to call her Mother Glenn, as she has asked. Mother Glenn, are you with us?
Rita, thank you.
Thank you for being on. How are you this evening?
I'm doing great. Thank you so much for having me on.
Of course. I'm just really pleased to have you. And so I want to start with the conversation that I just had. And was there anything that resonated with you?
I think almost everything you said did. It is just so profound, and I think that's something that we as women need so desperately in our lives because we are such nurturers that we tend to everybody else and we forget about us. And if we're not what we need to be, then we cannot give out what God has intended for us to give out. So I think that the things that you were saying about savoring the moment, And to be real honest, Rita, until I had an episode a couple of years ago that slowed me down, I didn't pay a lot of attention to that. But I thank God that I now have learned how to say no. It's still hard, but I think the first time I told, you know, my family no about something, I think they were all in shock. But we as women need to learn how sometimes to say no. You've got to have that break for yourself. I learned that I can't be, you know, everywhere all the time, and so sometimes I just have to say no, even if it hurts me. I know that I need to go home. I need to be by myself. I need to take some time. I need to have some time to read, to study. I have to refuel myself before I can give out. So many things that you talked about, the ministry of presence, just being in the present and sitting down with the children and talking to them. And I think so many times in this day and time, we have the iPads and the iPhones, and mothers, they're talking to their kids, but they're on their phones. And it's not, you know, when we were growing up, Rita, we sat down by the table and we all ate dinner
exactly.
at one time. It was no eating when you got ready. We all had a family meal, and we sat down with no TV on, no, we didn't have telephones back in those days, but no TV on, and we sat down and we had pleasant conversations. Our mothers and fathers asked us how was our day, you know, what was going on. And it was beautiful. And I think that we've gotten away from that, being so busy and not understanding what is so important. We've gotten away from that family time, or even if it's just a mother or just a father, just taking that time with those children.
Well, Mother Glenn, I want to ask this because I'm thinking about a client that just I had in today, and we were talking about this whole notion of being busy in time. How do you explain to women that taking time for yourself is not being selfish?
Absolutely. I think that when you look at Jesus, Jesus went off by himself. He took time when he had dealt with all the multitude.
Oh, that's good.
He said, I'm getting out of here. He said, I have to go. I have to go. I have to spend time for myself. And he had to actually go and get rejuvenated himself, because the multitudes had pulled on him so tremendously. And so we as women, we're not better than Jesus. If women had to, if Jesus had to take a day,
you
then
know that
certainly
we
need to take that time.
Right. And when I look at, because I'm a very visual person, and so I see me pouring as a coach, pouring into other people. And as I pour, then that's coming out of me.
Absolutely.
And so the more I pour, the more that comes out of me. And so I cannot expect to continue pouring in effectively if I am not receiving.
Absolutely.
And so
you've got to sit down and receive for yourself and get refueled. Or what you're giving out, probably not what God really intends for you to give out. You're doing it kind of halfway.
And I want to make sure before we move on that when we talk about sitting down, that, you know, because I hear folks, women say, well, you know, I get my nails done and I get my and all that's good. But we usually have the phone. I mean, we're on the phone or we're listening to music. And I want to make sure that our listeners understand when we're talking about being present in God's presence.
Right, absolutely.
There is total silence. You can't be doing anything. There has to be total silence in order to really be able to hear. And so you can't be haphazardly doing that. Oh, I'm listening to God. And I have clients who say, well, you know, I talk to God all the time. And then, of course, I ask, so are you listening? Are you listening?
You're right.
Yeah. So I want to move on because I do see in your resume that you had really a situation that appeared hopeless at one time. Can you share that with us?
Yes, without taking too much time, I had a situation where I got up out of the bed and went into the restroom and I just passed out. I don't even remember any of that. But what my husband tells me is that I passed out. My head was lodged into the marble in my bathroom. When he took my head off of that, I had a big gash in my head. It was not bleeding. I had no pulse. I my eyes were fixed. He was a police officer, so he knows the look of death, and he knew that I was gone. He started pleading the blood of Jesus over death. I had my baby daughter that came in, and she saw me, and she knew right off, Mama is gone. And the only thing she knew to do was to go in and get my pitcher, put some olive oil on it, and lay on the floor and cry and pray. My other daughter came into the bathroom, and she saw my husband beating my chest so hard that she was afraid he was going to hurt me. And so she said, she knew, looking at me, that I was dead. I mean, if my my head was gashed open. There was no blood, so
right.
my heart wasn't pumping. And she said, "Daddy, let me have her." And she took me from him, and she started working with me. And eventually I lost all my bodily fluids. And eventually I took a deep breath and then another one. And then when I did that, all the blood started gashing, just started going
gushing.
All over the bathroom, gushing all over the bathroom. And I had a bleeder from that. I was in the hospital for a week. The doctors said that I was a walking miracle. They said that it was no way that I should have been doing as well as I was with a bleeder like I had. And they said most people with a bleeder like that, they suffer long term. And I have nothing. I mean, it's like nothing ever happened. You can kind of see the gash in my face. But other than that, God has given me total, total healing. It was just amazing.
So you were just in the hospital for a week?
In the week. What happened, every day they took me for a CAT scan. And on the, I think it was the fifth day, they came, and every day they saw the blood on my brain. So they said, "We're probably going to have to do surgery to try to go in and see what's going on with this blood." And then one day they came in and they said, "We don't know what happened, but there is no more blood." And we said, "We know what happened.
Sure.
God did that." Yeah, God
sure.
just dried the blood out without any type of brain damage at all. And so my neurologist was just astonished. He said, "I need you to know that you are a walking miracle."
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So
there's a purpose.
There was nothing leading up to that?
No. I sat up in the bed and told my husband, "Leave the light on," because my stomach was a little queasy.
Mm-hmm.
And from that point until I woke up in the hospital, I remember nothing. And I asked my neurologist, "How did that happen?" And he said that sometimes right before a traumatic injury, you forget everything. So I actually don't even remember getting out the bed.
Okay.
My husband said I didn't turn the light on in the bathroom. He just heard a large thump.
Right.
And when he came in there, my hands were turned up. Like I wasn't even able to brace my fall. I just fell straight out. And I don't know anything. I don't know anything that happened.
Have you had any revelations as a result of that occurrence, that experience?
No, I can't say. I can't say that I have. I know that God didn't do it for me. I know that I feel that miracle was for other people.
Mm-hmm.
It's not because I'm good or perfect or nothing like that. It was not about me. But I believe I'm supposed to tell of this miracle because people need to know that there's hope here on earth, that
exactly.
miracles did not stop in the Bible, that he is still able and he will perform miracles. And I feel like I'm supposed to tell it. You know, I have a reason that I'm supposed to tell people about this so that they can have hope.
I think so. I think so. I am a breast cancer survivor since 99. And I just know that experience, like you said, is for me to share with people and to get them to understand how you have to live and you have to pay attention to your health and you have to take care of you because the body is a miracle in itself.
Absolutely, yeah.
The body is a miracle
all in
itself. And God is watching us. One of my favorite is Psalm 139. He's over us, under us, around us.
Around us.
Everywhere we go.
Right, everywhere.
He's there.
Yeah.
So why should we ever fear? But I'm getting off, and I want to come back. Because
okay.
I noticed that you, obviously, like I, love working with women. And I see that you want to deliver a word that will free women from the dark hour experiences everywhere. Is that what you do with your experience?
Yes. With this experience, and I've had a lot of experiences in my life, and when I look back over my life and I think of everything that God has delivered me from and helped me through, I know that he knew a long time ago that I had purpose. I didn't know it. I didn't understand it. And I think that that's where a lot of women are. They're going through hard times, and they're not understanding that it's for their good, and they're going to be able to come out of it victorious, and they're going to be able to help other women.
I need you to, you know, what you said is just so true, that we have to go through these. We have to go through these challenges. We have to experience them.
Correct.
Because
right.
God is trying to build, he wants to build our character, and it is for our good. And so if we look at it as good, because the breast cancer for me taught me how to eat differently. I was a terrible eater, and I drank sodas like tomorrow was the end of the world, and I was not taking care of this body. And somebody said to me one time, if my body fails me, where will I live?
You're right. You don't have anything left.
Where will I live?
Yeah.
And so that breast cancer really put me on another path. So if we look at it as something positive, even though we don't necessarily know why, I just know that God makes no mistakes.
That's right. That's right.
He doesn't make mistakes. And
it's
just really, it's something that we have to pay attention to. So
Absolutely. This
is what I'm going to do. I have to stop to hear our sponsors, some more sponsors. But when we come back, I want to talk about all of the hats that you wear and how you balance that. And then I want to talk about the conference that's coming up in April. So
all right,
let me just
you.
Read this one sponsor. NWHY Radio Network is proud to bring you Healthy, Wealthy, and Wise RVA Expo. So remember, the one that Sharice is doing is this coming Saturday. The one I'm talking about now is not until September 12th. It's going to be a complete mall takeover for entrepreneurs, family, teens, and you to enjoy. Come for the resources you can use to be successful in business. Stay for the live performances by the hosts of the network and entertainers from around the world. You don't want to miss this event. We're talking September 12th from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. You can register for free tickets today at healthywealthywiserva.eventbrite.com. Join us at the Chesterfield Town Center Mall, and we are looking forward to seeing you there live for the Healthy, Wealthy, and Wise RVA event from NWHY Radio. We'll be right back. Stay with me.
The Queen Esther Radio Show is live every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Join me, Jessica Taylor.
And me, Jason Mosley, to be entertained by authors, artists, and spiritual leaders.
We look forward to being a blessing in your life every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Only on the NWHY Radio Network.
The Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show is happy to announce our partnership with the May We Help You Radio Network. You can now catch the rebroadcast of our Wednesday show every Thursday at 6 p.m. That's Tanya Free and Friends, the podcast, every Thursday evening at 6 p.m. We welcome your comments and opinions 24/7 at TanyaFree.com, Facebook and Twitter, or send me a text by texting the word Tanya, that's 72727. Tanya Free and Friends, and May We Help You Radio. Living life with a purpose.
Hi, this is Capri Smith of the Uncuffed Radio Show. Join me every Saturday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to learn how you can grow in your business, personal environment, and reach your true potential by uncuffing what is binding you, only on the Maybe Help You Radio Network.
Hi, my name is Leticia M., owner of May We Help You Network. I want to thank you for joining us and enjoying our host here on MWHY Radio Network. Please visit us online at MWHYradio.com and like us on Facebook.com/MWHYradio. Tune in to learn more about our hosts and upcoming contests. and our TV programming that'll be coming to you soon. MWHY Radio, bringing together business, community, and you.
Thank you for staying with me. This is Rita Ricks, and you're listening to Spirit Journeys Radio. If, in fact, you're on your computer, you can dial 646-652-2512 if you'd like to talk with us before the show is over. And if you're already listening, all you have to do is press 1. And Mother Glenn, are you with us?
I am. I'm here.
All right. And before we move on, you said you know that your daughters are on?
They're all three listening, yes.
Okay, call their names so that they will just know that they know we know they're on.
I have Marjorie, Catherine, and my baby Dora that's 28, Amanda.
I love it. Hey, ladies, I'm glad you're on. Your mom is so wonderful to talk to. So, Mother Glenn, with great joy, you balance being a wife, a mother, a nana, a first lady, a counselor, and a friend. How long have you and your husband been married?
We've been married 35 years.
Which is phenomenal. Tell me how you do it. How do you do it? How do you find time to be the wife that clearly you are being for him, and the nana and the counselor and then first lady for the whole church, and we know that in itself is a responsibility, being a mom and then being you. Talk to me.
All right. Well, I tell you, Rita, I think that the main thing that I tried to do was to keep everything in perspective, understanding that my first responsibility and my first ministry is at home. So I had to, while my children were growing up, I did the best that I could, but I tried to keep home first. I mean, it was a couple of times I wanted to go to school. I tried to go to school. I finished a course, and it seemed like my house was going haywire, so I'd quit and I'd come back home. And I had to just really realize that it's not about me. You know, I chose to have a husband. I chose to have children. So it wasn't about me having to have a degree or having to go to school. My first ministry was at home. And once my kids got older and they, you know, got grown, married, and out of the house, I can devote more time now to the church. But me and my husband still find that time to spend time by ourselves. We are not, we take care of the church, but we still have that separate time. And I just feel like I just have always known. I saw my mother do it. She didn't have a church and all that, but I saw my mother take care of her household in a way that I wanted to emulate. And I wanted to make sure I was the best mother, the best wife that I could be. So everything else had to kind of fall in place.
Right. And I had a mom the same way. My dad was military, so we traveled all over. And it didn't matter where we were. It didn't matter what kind of house we had. My mom made it a home.
That's right. And that's where we were, too. We were military.
Yeah. Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And so you could see that. And so I'm sure it concerns you as much as it concerns me when we have young ladies who have babies and say, I don't need the daddy, I don't need the man, blah, 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 blah. I just think that's such a huge challenge. And they don't have anybody to they don't have a role model.
Right, right, absolutely.
And so it's up to those of us who know to share with them and to love them and encourage them. I just feel that way.
Yeah, and I do too, and that's, you know, one of our missions to do when we have these conferences and different functions, that we try to instill that in women. I think one reason that why women do not take care of themselves because they don't value themselves. Mm-hmm. And one thing that we try to preach and teach to women, that they are special treasures, they are God's chosen generation, they are royal priesthood, and try to get them to see how special and important they are in God's eyesight so they can appreciate themselves. Because when you understand who you are and appreciate yourself, then you can do better by those around you.
Sure, sure. And I have said to women before, especially the single moms that I work with, if you wake up in the morning with a smile on your face, Your children are going to go to school that way. They're going to impact
right.
the bus drivers, the teachers, the principal, the cafeteria people,
yes.
and it is just going to permeate throughout the entire system. But if
You're
you
right.
wake up in an ugly mood, that's going to happen as well.
And I've got to throw a quick, I got to
mm-hmm.
throw a quick anecdote in here. When my
mm-hmm.
kids were going to school, I would tell their daddy, and I would do everything I could. I said, we cannot, you don't scold the kids before they go to school. You
mm-hmm.
don't fuss at them. You don't spank them. You don't do whatever. You
right.
make their morning as pleasant as it can be.
Right.
And whatever
That's
we
right.
need to deal with, we
That's
will
right.
deal with when they get out of school. Because
That's right.
I was bound determined not to send my kids to school mad,
upset.
Angry, because all it was going to do was go into the classroom
yes.
and cause a whole
yes.
lot of problems.
And,
so
and,
that
and
was
it
a
just
joke.
Permeates.
That's right, and that's a joke right now of my daughter's. My mama said, oh, no, she wasn't going to, my daughter said, no, she wasn't going to make you upset before you went to school, but wait till you got home.
And you might, and you're going to catch it then, but you got all day to work on it.
That's right.
I love it. I
love
that's
it. That's
right. So I want to get back real quickly, like my brother and his wife, they have date nights. Do you all have date nights?
Yes, yes.
Okay,
we absolutely do. We take that time to go to a movie, to do something that's other than church. You cannot be just. You just can't do the church thing. You got to have time to spend with your
Absolutely.
With your husband. And we go out of town. We go out of town a lot. We take a lot of vacations
Good.
Because as busy as we are during
Good.
The week and during the months, we have to get away to
mm-hmm.
to rest our minds.
Good.
Yeah.
So that going away, and I just think that's so wonderful, that going away allows you to spend time with him, but also to spend time with yourself, and that's the nourishing piece that we were talking about
right.
earlier. So when you come back, you're refreshed and you're ready to meet. It's I'm so proud of y'all. I really
That's right. Thank
am.
You.
I am.
Thank you.
I am so proud of y'all.
Thank
so
you, bless
I want
you.
To tell you that I received, I'm moving on, but I received over the email information about this conference, Women with Mission and Purpose in His Presence. And
yes.
I printed it off immediately because I got it back in January, and the theme for the month of January was being purposeful, for February was being purposeful. And so I want you to talk about this conference, please.
Okay, the In His Presence, I believe God gave that to me. Every conference is In His Presence. Sometimes we have an additional theme, but this year it's just In His Presence. And what we do, we come together as women. I think this is a good time. It's just like getting a tune-up for your car. Women
Right.
need to get away from their spouses. They need to get away from their children. They need to have time to spend. And I'm going to tell you, Rita, from the start of our conference to the end, we don't give no whole bunch of accolades or nothing like that to this one and that one. We are worshiping, we are teaching, we are actually just trying to stay in His presence. Not a whole lot of other stuff goes on. We dedicate those 2 days to being in His presence. With everything we do, it's all about Jesus. It's not about me, it's not about you, it's not about anybody, but
Right.
it's all about Jesus. And that's what we do. We have sessions for young girls. We started at 16, but then some of the mothers wanted to bring younger kids, so we go from 13 to 21 where
Okay.
they are away from us and they have their own sessions, and that has been absolutely phenomenal.
Wow.
We teach women that they are queens. And so this conference, and at every conference I have a standard thing that I do, and that is to choose a woman and a youth to bring up and crown, and it's a beautiful song.
Really?
It talks about, oh my gosh, it's so moving. It's a beautiful song called Royalty, and it
mm-hmm.
talks about when you were a little girl, you were a princess, but then something happened that made you forget that you were a princess. And then
mm-hmm.
he says, I'm calling you back. This is your coronation day to understand that you are a princess. And,
yes.
and so it's, and I crown them, and it's just, it's phenomenal. And it's just, it's a time to just empower women to understand who they are.
And I love it because we cannot allow any situation to define us.
Right.
And if we choose to stay in the moment of that crowning, if we choose to stay in the moment will never end. Because
That's
we
continue right.
to stay in the moment. But we
yes.
have to decide. And I get this a lot because my clients will say, well, this is what happened back then, and therefore, but that was then, and this is now.
Now, absolutely.
And so we have to stay above the fray, and it's so important. If we get caught up in, you know, every time the phone rings, every time one of our children calls us or a girlfriend calls us and starts going, yada, 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 if we get caught up in it, we'll be in the middle of it.
That's
and
right.
So stay above it. Know that this situation that is in your life right now is just here for a little while, and then
right.
guess what? It's going to leave. And
it's
going to be followed
right.
by another one.
That's right. That's right.
And
that's
so
right. It's a season
up.
That we have to go through.
Yes.
Yes.
So don't get
yes.
caught up in the situation. Begin to miss. If you're in the moment, if you're mindful of what's going on, you choose to look at the beauty of it, you can actually look at the situation and smile and say, see ya.
That's right. That's right. I won't be here long. I'm coming out. That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right. So what day is this, is the conference? And tell give me a little bit.
It starts Friday the 17th at 9:30, and
okay.
we'll have sessions. I think the we'll have sessions all day Friday, and then it'll end about 4, and then
okay.
come back Friday night at 7 p.m. for a main session. That's where I'll be speaking. And
mm-hmm.
then Saturday, and that's at our church, and then Saturday we move to the Doubletree Koga Center, and
oh.
we'll start with a breakfast. And we have a speaker for the breakfast and then an afternoon speaker. And we'll end about 4 o'clock.
Okay. Excellent. And so is there a cost?
Yes. It's $65 for $65. I think it's $55 for seniors and $35 for youth. I
okay.
think that's right, but it's on our website.
And what's the website?
The website is www.ndec.com. Dot net.
Okay. NDEC. Very good.
Dot
very
net.
Good.
Yes, ma'am.
And how long have you been doing this?
17 years. This is our 17th year.
Really?
Yes, yes.
And
sometimes we stay in Richmond and sometimes we go out of town.
Okay. Okay. And where have you been when you've been out of town?
We've gone to Williamsburg. Last year we were in Hampton at the Embassy Suites.
Okay.
And last year it was from the pit to the palace.
Mm-hmm.
And so women went through the pit on Friday night. And then Saturday, all 500 women I crowned personally. And
no.
you're talking about, yes. And you're talking about a moving. And women are still talking about, I'm still in my palace. They understand
yes.
the concept that, yes, I'm going through. But I'm not being evicted out of my palace. I'm going to live
right.
and reign in my palace. So it was
it.
A very effective conference last year where everybody was crowned. And we try to do that maybe every 5 years where we bring all the women back in and crown everybody.
I really hope that women that are listening tonight, it's as you said, April 17th, and it starts,
yes.
at 9:30. And the website
yes.
is www.ndnc, I'm sorry, NDEC.
Correct.
For New Deliverance Evangelistic Church.
Church.
And that's dot com,
net.
Dot net.
Dot net.
Dot net. That's great. Tell me this, Mother Glenn, what do you know for sure?
Well, I think I know for sure that God reigns in my life. And that he has everything in control, and not just my life, but everybody else's, if we will allow him to.
Hmm.
If we will allow him to. He's the perfect gentleman. He's not going to mess with you if you don't mess with him.
I love it. I love it. Have you always been in a relationship with him?
Absolutely not. I've been saved, I think, about 36 years now. I got saved about a year before I got married.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And before then, it was a major struggle.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I've like I said, God, this miracle he did a couple of years ago was not my first one. He saved me from suicide 3 times.
No.
And I had no clue that I had a purpose, but I do have a purpose to tell other women that no matter what
Absolutely.
You're going through, there's nothing,
Absolutely.
Nothing that can be better than God. God can handle it all.
Mother Gwen, do you believe everybody has a purpose?
Yes. Yes.
I do too.
I believe everybody is born with a purpose.
That's why we're here.
Yes.
And I tell people all the time that we are waiting for you to just walk in your purpose. We're
That's
waiting.
Right.
The planet is going to be better as
yes.
a result of you following the purpose that God placed
That's
you
right.
there with.
That's right.
Yeah.
I believe that. I believe
yeah.
that.
Yeah. And
it just
and
takes us a while sometimes.
I was just getting ready to say that I know that it's difficult when you've got all of these hats. You're wearing all of these hats. I understand it. But it's so much easier if you take the time to be silent and to listen to him, not talk to him all the time, but just to listen to him and allow
yes.
him to guide your day, just to
yes.
direct your path on a daily basis.
Right, absolutely.
And that just and so what happens is that what for me, when I finally turned it over to him, and that's just been since about 2009, where I just
mm-hmm.
really left it at the altar, the weight has been lifted from me because it's not me anymore. I'm
that's
following
right.
him.
And it's easy when you follow him.
It's easy, and there is
yes.
a freedom. So people say,
yes.
people need to understand there is a freedom when you recognize you are not in charge.
That's right. That's right. When we try
yeah.
to do it, it's a lot harder.
Mm-hmm.
But if we just let him guide us, you're right, it's so much easier.
Mm-hmm.
So much easier.
Yeah. And it makes it really special. Do you
yes,
have any last thoughts? Is there anything else that you want to share? Because you just have just been phenomenal. You
oh,
are the diamond in the rough that I love.
Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that. No, I don't think so. I think we've covered so many things. I think that if I could leave anything with them, I was really impressed when you were talking about taking no thought, pay attention to just this moment and taking no thought of tomorrow and yesterday. And I think that's one thing that has helped me so much is to not to be a worrywart, is to
mm-hmm.
just be in the moment. Today is the day. I cannot figure out tomorrow. I cannot change yesterday. So just living in the moment has helped
right.
me to not be a person that just worries because, number one, I might not be living tomorrow. So
mm-hmm.
why am I going to worry about something that might not even happen or I might not even be here for?
Mm-hmm.
So when we look at it like that, it takes tension off of us. So if I can say anything to women, just live in the moment.
And then you're missing the
what's happening
the
right
solution.
Now. Absolutely. Absolutely.
The solution
Absolutely.
Might be right in front of your face.
Right in front of your face, yes,
mm-hmm.
yes,
mm-hmm.
yes.
Mother Gwen, I want to also publicly thank Miss Renita Christian. She was just wonderful to work with.
Well,
so
thank you.
I
she's a sweetheart.
Say,
she's my right hand. Thank you.
I just wanted to say thank you. I know she's listening, and I know we talked 3 or 4 times today. She knows. She talked to me one time while I was waiting for the person that I took to the doc. I actually walked around the Walmart parking lot because I needed to get my walk in. So I'm talking and to her while I'm walking. She's just been very special. So I want to
she
thank
is.
Her as well.
She is. Thank you. I appreciate you
Absolutely.
Recognizing that.
And so I'm going to say goodnight to you. It was wonderful having you on, and I look forward to meeting you.
Yes, I look forward to meeting you, too, and being involved in some of the things that you're doing. Some of the items that you've got going on, they're just absolutely wonderful, and I'm looking to be involved in some of that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Rita. I appreciate you.
Okay, have a great rest of the evening. Good night.
You do the same. Good night.
So I can't tell you how really pleased I am at having met with this person this evening. This woman is just phenomenal, and so I enjoyed it so much. I hope that you did as well. I want to remind you that my website is www.speaktoyourspirit.com. And you can go on there, and as Mother Glenn mentioned, I've got the Listening to the Silence retreat. That is every third Tuesday, all day at Richmond Hill. All you have to do is go to the website to get more information and to find out how to register. We have Breathe every fourth Thursday. We just had Breathe. We had a great time. I've got a picture of it on Facebook. on my spirit page. I'd like for you to go to my spirit page and like it, because I'm going to be a lot more active on that page moving forward. So please go to my Facebook spirit page and like it. You know you can follow me on Twitter as well. Also, I have a blog, and I'd love for you to follow that. I always put today's program on my blog, and so it goes onto my website. It also goes on YouTube, and so you can go back and hear any of the other programs or any of the archive programs that we have. This has been 5 weeks, and we've had 5 Tuesdays this month, and so we've spent a lot of time talking about the present. I would love to hear from you. I would love to hear how it has changed your life. I did hear from some of you last week because I actually spent a couple of minutes in silence, and I heard from many of you later saying that you enjoyed that. So you know that most of the time that I'm the only one doing the program and I don't have a guest, we will probably do a silence because the silence is that important to me. We talked about in January, we talked about being silent. In February, the theme was being purposeful. This month, it is about being present. Next month, we're going to be talking about being authentic. What does it mean to be authentic? And remember, I told you, each month, the theme just, everything builds on top of the one that we had last month. So I really want you to continue to listen. I am so grateful that you are a part supporting me. And I want to spend, I just want to say before we leave, and I read this in the beginning, but I want to read it one more time. And this was suggested that you choose one thing, do it to the best of your ability, let it go, pick something else, and repeat endlessly. We cannot spend our lives looking back over our shoulders. We just can't, because we can't do anything about that. We can't spend our lives looking ahead and worrying, because as Mother Glenn said, worry just makes you ill, causes you to be sick. Worry brings on stress, and stress, it'll kill you. It will absolutely kill you. But if you just focus on this moment, because there is no other moment, if you just focus on this moment, I promise you, life will be so much better. It has nothing to do with you making more money. It has nothing to do with you moving into a bigger house. It has nothing to do with you finding the perfect mate. It has to do with you enjoying and appreciating who you are right now, right this minute, who you are. You are not defined by what any human. You are defined by the fact that you are one of God's children, and he loves you. He absolutely, unconditionally loves you. And I have to tell you, I like you a lot, too. So I thank you for being on tonight. I'm Rita, speaking to your spirit. Good night.